Hello, everyone, and welcome inside the CIF. I'm your host, Richard Thiemann, and this is your Game of the Week preview for week number 6 of the 2021 CIF season. Now, some of you may have gone and looked ahead at the schedule and saw what should be the obvious choice for this week, and that is part 2 of the I-29 rivalry, the Omaha Beef versus the Sioux City Bandits, Sunday, May 2nd at 4:05 p.m. You also might be thinking, well, wait, this was the game of the week just a couple of weeks ago. Well, scheduling, what do? We make the best of what we've got. But this one did not disappoint last time. We don't believe that it will disappoint this time either. And of course, the third and final one will be the final week of the regular season. However, there couldn't be more on the line for these two teams, as Sioux City has suffered its first loss against Salina and are 3-1, and the Beef, coming fresh off of a bye, are 1-2. A win for the Beef would put them right back into the playoff picture, but a loss would put them into a hole that I don't think they want to try to dig out of. So, the standings as of right now for the CIF season are: the Salina Liberty sit alone atop the CIF standings as the only undefeated team at 5-0. Then we have the Sioux City Bandits at 3-1, the Wyoming Mustangs 2-2, the Omaha Beef 1-2, the Dodge City Law 1-1, and the Wichita Force 1-2. Today I'm joined by wide receiver Tyler Jones of the Omaha Beef and the Swiss Army Knife of the Sioux City Bandits, wide receiver, linebacker, and kicker Braden Meints. This should be a great conversation, so let's go ahead and preview the Week 6 Game of the Week. Alright fans, once again it is Rivalry Week. We have Part 2 of the I-29 rivalry between the Omaha Beef and Sioux City Bandits. This time it is up in Sioux City at the Tyson Event Center. And here to talk all about it, representing the away team this time, is wide receiver Tyler Jones from Central Missouri. Welcome, Tyler. How you doing?
I'm doing good. It's been a long week and we've got a lot to prove.
Yeah, you guys are coming off a bye week, and of course, there's not really the perfect time for a bye week, as I've talked to several players, and they're like, you know, when they happen, they happen, and hopefully it's when we feel we need it the most. And you guys were coming off a home loss, a tough one, against the opponent that you're going to be playing this upcoming week. Is that about as perfect timing as you can get to kind of shift back to neutral?
I think it couldn't have been a better time for us to recover, you know, from a lot of the hard work we've been putting in. You know, this bye week was very important because obviously we haven't started off the way we wanted to and what most of us are used to with obviously winning. So I think mostly the bye week is figuring out what we need to change and do differently to, you know, adapt so we can actually put points on the board, like, you know, most people prior to the season starting figured we would be able to do. And I think just that, you know, really picking each other's brains about what we think is not working and what is working and what we need to change, what we need to remove from the playbook offensively. And, you know, just really do what we have to do to win games.
Only 10 games in the world of football, every game counts. They really count in a season like this. And now you guys are going to play a team for the second time, second of three, and both are going to be in their house. So what do rivalries mean to you, especially with as much on the line as there is for this one?
Well, rivalries have always been something that, you know, for me personally, extra motivates, you know, how I play, how I prepare for that week. You know, the Salina week, I know everyone knows that a majority of the offense came from that organization. So for me personally, the Salina week was a huge rivalry game that a lot of us took more serious than probably most would have thought. But for the Omaha Beef organization, I know the Sioux City Bandits has been a rivalry for many years. And for the fans, you know, it's a must-win game. Like, you know, we have the best fans in the league. We have the best, you know, organization, in my opinion, in the league. And I think that we owe it to them to give them what they want.
So the big question then is, you have a record of 1-2 right now. You win, you're 500, you're 2-2. You're right in that playoff picture. They drop to 3-2. They will have lost two in a row, should that be the case. And things look a lot more interesting, and the future is pretty bright for the Omaha Beef as far as finishing out the rest of the season. However, you guys lose, you're 1-3, and with six teams, it's not an impossible hole to climb out of, but definitely not one you want to dig yourself into. So what does it mean for this game for you guys, and what do you have to do to win?
I think really it's just making these changes and executing them. You know, there's only so much that we can do, you know, as from the coaching aspect of things. You know, they can't go out there and do it for us. You know, all they can do is motivate and put us in the right spot to, you know, make plays. And I think that's what it's really going to come down to. Offensively, it's going to come down to, you know, the chemistry that we have built, you know, trusting in one another that, you know, we can do what we have to do to win this game. Everything we've been practicing, everything we've prepared through, you know, over the bye week, all the changes we've made personnel-wise, you know, all of that has to come together this game. And the most important thing is believing that we can actually do it.
It's only a 10-game regular season. Four teams will advance to the postseason. So although Salina is taken off with an undefeated record right now, the next three spots are very much up for grabs. So you guys got plenty of season ahead of you, but definitely want to get back on the right track this weekend in Sioux City. So Tyler, I thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right, once again, he is Tyler Jones, wide receiver for the Omaha Beef, part two of the I-29 rivalry. And I wish you the best of luck. I'll see you this weekend.
Sounds good. Thanks, Richard.
Thank you. All right, fans, it's now time for the home team and representing the Sioux City Bandits. He is what I would call a Swiss Army knife of indoor football. He is from Simpson College, Braden Meints. Welcome, Braden. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Doing well, and I gotta say, that title, I feel, personally, very fitting. It was funny when I was messaging your coach to see who he wanted to have on for this Game of the Week preview. He said, yeah, let's have it be Braden. He's kind of does everything. He's a wide receiver, a linebacker, a running back, and then, of course, even a kicker. So do you feel like you've achieved the status of indoor football Swiss Army knife?
I guess so. I just kind of try to do what the coaches ask me to do. And if I'm able to do it, I kind of just do, I guess.
Very modest of you. Very humble personality. I like it. Which of the positions I listed would you say is your favorite?
Probably anything where I'm on the field. I would probably have to say offense, though. I've been playing offensive side of the ball since I was a little kid. Obviously, I came from a small school, so I had to do a lot and learn a lot. So I think that's kind of where I get a lot of my skills, I guess.
I did see that you made the top 10 last week or 2 weeks ago for your Uno kick. And I believe you told me after the game you were not planning on that happening.
I was not planning on that at all. I think I stepped wrong and put it a little too far left, but obviously it counts as a point now, and I mean, it worked out in our favor, so it is what it is.
All right, well, let's get down to it. The reason we're here is we're previewing the game of the week for week number 6, which happens to be the Omaha Beef at the Sioux City Bandits, because the last one was in Omaha. And yes, for everybody, once again, if you're wondering why this was just the game of the week a few weeks ago, scheduling. What else can you say? So you guys are not coming off of a bye week like the Beef are. In fact, you're coming off of your first loss of the season, but I mean, it was to the still undefeated Salina Liberty. Looking back at that game, how do you feel overall as far as that possibly being like a measuring stick for where you guys are at this point in the season?
I'd say that it was definitely a good test for us. You know, we had a couple of injuries in the prior weeks that we've had to have guys fill in who aren't as experienced at those spots as the guys who were before them. Bruno went down. Hopefully, you know, he's back this week. If not, we've got guys that are willing to step up into those positions. I know a lot of things happened, you know, but the best thing that happened is that guys were always cheering each other up, helping each other out, and trying to, you know, next play, we're good, we got this, keep your chin up, you know, like that's kind of like the atmosphere that we got. It's a good culture over here, and guys just love up on each other all the time.
Hopefully, you know, you guys have taken note of what happened that game and are going to apply it to this one, but it is against a rival, which makes things interesting every time. How do you feel about rivalry games?
I think they're fun. You know, you get some jitters going into it, but after that first kickoff, no matter what it is, you kind of settle down and get into the zone again. And you kind of just go from there. Take each play as it is, and if a bad one happens, flush it, move on, next one.
You know, for you guys, you're coming off of a loss, and yes, you want to win. You want to win at home. You want to win against a rival. But this game probably means more for Omaha, who's at 1-2. If they win, they're back to 500, and the playoff picture gets very interesting. And if you guys win, though, you guys are still with just the one loss and put Omaha in a hole that will be very difficult for them to climb out of. But a loss, you guys still 3-2, not a terrible record by any means. But how do you feel about going up against an opponent knowing that the game really means more for them than maybe you guys do as far as the aspects like that?
You know, there could be, you know, times during the game where things might get a little chippy either way. You know, we saw that a little bit back at Omaha. But as long as we stay, you know, calm, cool, collected, I think we still are able to pull it out in the end, no matter what the score is. You know, I think, you know, if we can handle our own stuff and adversity, I think we'll be just fine.
Now, the third and final meeting between you guys will be the last week of the regular season, and who knows what's going to happen between this game and that one. But the competitor in you, I'm sure, wants to go out and get this W, even though it would hurt them a lot as far as what they do for the rest of the season. But does the competitor in you also want them to lose this one and then win the rest so that it really comes down to that last game of the season? Or would you rather have a little bit of peace of mind with 1 week left to go before playoffs?
I don't know. Yeah, you gave me the chills there. Just thinking about that kind of stuff. You know, if it happens to, you know, come down to that last game, we got a bit of an edge, you know. If we do win this game and they win the rest of theirs, you know, they're going to have a chip on their shoulder. I think always going into a game against Omaha, you have to have that edge, that, you know, animal mentality, where, you know, you take every play and you win it every play. If you don't, you got to come back and win the next one. So I think that would be really fun, actually.
All right, and the final question for you, the obvious one, what will it take for you guys to get a W this weekend against Omaha?
Consistency. Every single play, we have to be consistent. Everybody has to know what they're doing. You know, you can't make, you know, the same mistake over and over. If you make a mistake, fix it, come back, do it correctly, and never mess it up again. So that's one big thing for us this week is consistency.
Well, it sounds easy enough, doesn't it?
yeah, that's for sure.
All right. Well, Braden, I do wish you the best of luck this weekend. I will be there. I'm very excited for round two of this I-29 rivalry, be there live and in person to see it all play out. But, hey, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Rich. Thank you for the opportunity.
Absolutely. One more time, fans. He is the Swiss Army knife of indoor football, wide receiver, running back, linebacker, kicker. I think the only thing he can't be is a punter because there is no punting in indoor football. But he is Braden Meints of the Sioux City Bandits. Best of luck and thanks again. And one more big thank you to Tyler and Braden for joining me here on Inside the CIF to talk about round two of the I-29 rivalry. Don't forget, if you can't attend in person, you can watch the game live on the CIF Network channel on YouTube.com. The game is once again Sunday, May 2nd, kickoff, 4:05 p.m. Central Time. Who will be the next game of the week we preview? You'll just have to tune in and find out. Until then, I'm Richard Thiemann, and this is Inside the CIF.